normally we would put the jump board on if you're testing, right? We're not gonna do the jump board because we've talked about the jump board over and over again many times, right? Clarifying the breath on the jump board, I learned an inhale out, exhale return. If you have to modify for some reason, I also learned that the legs are gonna go above the jump board. If the legs migrate down, you know that they're not stabilizing the weight of their legs. You know that they're using their back and not their core. I mean, the back is part of the core, but they're not using their whole core. People, you will see people migrate down the jump board, and as they get lower and lower, it's like, okay.
Or even worse, their legs
are losing.
Dead.
Yeah,
dead.
Right. So it's that, right, the leg reaches out, and then you return.
For the test out, is there any specifics on
like
double
legs,
single
legs?
No specifics,
just
show me
the momentum.
Okay.
Okay. But other than that, we're gonna go more side splits. Okay. Now, when we were level one, level basic, when we were doing side splits, when we were introducing side splits, we're using a heavy spring. It changes the exercise, it changes the mechanics and the force of the exercise, right? You have to use your lateral stabilizers rather than your medial inner thigh adductors. At this stage of the game, you should be using a relatively light spring, right? Mm-hmm. Let's just good. Now, when we get on, what do we talk about with the inner thigh and the stability?
The carriage shouldn't move.
Right, and that's another thing that I've seen in places. It's like they put the split plate on, and then they step both feet onto this, and I'm like, no. You don't have a mastery of the machine if you're always stepping on a stable base. That's my job as a teacher, is to teach you how to have mastery over this unstable surface, because guess what? When you leave the